Hi, my name is Emily, and in this video, we'll be working off on an extension for our web scraper exercise. So in the previous two videos, I walked through how to make a basic web scraper for the Class Util website. But now I'm going to talk about how you can modify your program slightly by using options on the command line. So now we want to still run the Util scraper program, but if the user puts in dash s at any point in the program, we want to specify that we want to output a summary statistic. So before we outputted one line per lecture stream, but this is a little bit verbose. Maybe you want to see how full the course is overall. So over all lecture streams, how full is it? So the percentage summary that we want to output is, we want to sum all the percentage fulls across all lecture streams and then divide it by the number of lecture streams. So that gives us a nice average. And that is what's outputted in these first two examples. So if when I specify four courses, I only get four lines. So to do that, we need to modify our program to look for that dash s option. And up top in our argv, if we want to look for a dash s option, we need to be able to search through this argv array kind of quickly. And the way we can do that is with the grep program. So the grep program, it lets us search for an expression within a list. And the great thing about the grep program is you can use it for both searching for an item in a list and also for weeding out things you don't want. So if I first search for the dash s option, I can get rid of it from the argv list by saying not dash s. That means I can maintain my same loop across my argv so that everything there is now a course. Because if I try to iterate through course, but the course is actually a dash s, it makes no sense. It's going to break my regex and everything. So I'll make sure once I get to this loop, my argv no longer has that option dash s if it was present. So to do that, the first thing is I want to look for the summary statistic option. Let's set the default value to be 0. So I'm just say by default, no one wants a summary statistic. But if I use grep and I look for a dash s, so it starts with a dash s and that's the only thing on there in the argv array. So if that's true, that means they want a summary. So I should set that summary variable that I'm using internally in my program to 1. And I want to get rid of all of the dash s's from my argv, otherwise that for loop is going to break. So I can reassign my argv to be everything that's not a dash s over here, and the array I want to be filtering is that argv array. So that should do it, but again, you just want to print out some things for sanity checking. So I want to print out the state of my summary variable is summary, and I want to make sure my argv array no longer has that dash s. So print argv is argv over there. And let's look back at our program. So if I had util scraper comp2041-s comp151, summary is 1, that's good because I specified the dash s. Argv is comp2041 and comp1511, but there's no dash s in that array anymore. So that sounds pretty good. Let's make sure it also works for when I don't specify the option. So summary is 0, argv is comp2041. Looks good to me. So now I know I have a variable called summary that I can work with. And whenever I want to change my printing behavior, I look and check the summary flag variable. So it's quite important in my code. So now I look at all the places where I have been changing my printing behavior. So usually we just print it in this line. But that's what we want to do if no summary has been specified. So if summary is 0, then we want to retain our old printing behavior. Otherwise, looking at our formula here, we want to have some sort of sum of all of the percent fulls we've seen. So we've calculated a percent full variable, but we want to keep on summing that as we go. And we want a counter of the number of lecture streams seen. So in this case, we don't want to straight up just print. We want to calculate those variables. So let's declare our variables outside. If our summary is 1, we want to say that we want to have a total percent. Let's set that to 0 first. And a num streams, also set that to 0. And if that's the case, we want over here to increment our total percent by percent full. And we want to increment our num streams by 1, because we've seen another lecture stream in this part of the loop where we found lec and then some percent that's not closed. So that's not a lecture stream. That's all good, but at some point we do have to print this. And it's going to be after we figure out all the lecture stream information. So outside of this while loop over here, we want to add a variable check. So we want to check if summary was 1, that means we haven't printed anything yet. We've only been in this else case where we've gotten the total percentage and num streams we need. So we need to calculate the summary percentage, which is just total percentage divided by num streams. And then we need to print it out. And if we look back at the format, we want to see the course code, lectures are how many percent full overall. That's the format we want to match. So let's print course lectures are summary perk percent full overall. That's what we want. And again, let's test it. We think it's all right, but let's double check that. So now with our util scraper, we'll match our previous behavior. Comp2041. Over here, we only get one statement now, and both lectures were 100% full, so that's the right correct summary statistic. So util scraper dot pl put psych 1011 dash s comp 1511 comp 2041 econ 1102, and we get 4 lines as we expect. So that's what we're working with, and we can see that our dash s option is working, but let's make sure it works for when we don't specify as well, so that our original behavior is retained. And now we do get that one print statement per lecture stream as we had before. So looking back at this code, the important thing when you want to specify an option is to use grep to look for that option in your argv arrays, set some sort of flag variable for yourself for later on in the program, and then get rid of the option from the argv array so that your loop works as normal. And then everywhere you want to print, you want to wrap that within your if statement to check which kind of printing mode am I specifying. Is it no summaries or do I want a summary? That's what I'm doing over here. And sometimes you might need to put the print statement somewhere else as well if you want to print a summary statistic. So hopefully you now know how to extend your program to use options, which is a very common task you might be faced with in your labs. And this is the end of our web scraping tutorial. I hope you've learned a lot, and best of luck in your labs.